Good morning. It's Wednesday, February 15th, and you're watching Eagle Eye News. I'm Zach Harris.
And I'm Tristan.
Let's get right into the announcements.
Thank you, Student Council, for organizing our 3-day Spirit Week of Fun. Tomorrow will be Twin Day, so dress and match like your buddy. Friday will be Snowball Day or Whiteout.
Following the week's activities, Student Council will be hosting the Snowball Dance in the North Campus Common Space, following Friday's home basketball game. Admission is $10 and paid at the door.
Speaking of Friday's festivities, there will be a special performance happening at the basketball game. Let's find out who.
This Friday, Hudsonville versus Jenison, the Eagle Claw Drumline. Let them rock you. Go!
Juniors and seniors, if you're interested in meeting with an admissions representative from Muskegon Community College, an Institute of Agricultural Technology, look for a sign-up in your email. The meeting will take place tomorrow at 1 p.m. in the main campus Media Center Rotunda.
Are you suffering from the midwinter blues? Then we have a solution. Tame those hunger pains with white cheddar or Chicago-style popcorn for only $1 per bag. Stop by Mr. Heading's room 162 and grab yourself a well-deserved snack.
Attention Renaissance Gold members. The business of the month for February is Vitalis of Hudsonville. You will receive one free order of breadsticks with sauce, to-go orders only, and you must show your BOM card and student ID.
There is a sign-up sheet in the athletic office for all boys interested in the golf team this spring. There will be a player/parent meeting today at 5:15 p.m. in room 309.
For anyone interested in boys track this spring, there will be a meeting and sign-ups right after school on Thursday. We will meet in Mr. Bullheis's room, 315. Please make every effort to be there.
Attention any freshman or sophomore girl going out for softball. There will be an informational meeting Friday at 7:20 a.m. in room 305, which is the connector hallway right across from the new main office.
The Hudsonville Esports Overwatch team dominated their first preseason match, winning 4-0 against Henry Ford Academy. Fire up.
Here are the birthdays for today, February 15th.
Slick will be partnering with Kids Food Basket this Friday at the varsity basketball game. Please bring an extra dollar or two to donate to the cause. Kids Food Basket is committed to helping young children get the dinner they need and deserve each night. In order to support this cause, we will be decorating bags, collecting money throughout the stands, and collecting money at the concessions during halftime for KFB. Please consider donating at the game this Friday. Every penny helps. For more on KFB, let's take a look.
For many kids in our community, this bag means lunch doesn't have to be the last meal of the day. It gets its life at Kids Food Basket with the support of people like you. People who hold juice box and snack drives. People who decorate brown paper bags. Organizations like Feeding America, which provide food at discounted rates. Farmers who provide fresh, local produce. And hundreds of volunteers each weekday who bring all the pieces together to create a well-rounded, nutritious evening meal for thousands of kids. and then deliver these meals to dozens of schools and summer sites throughout West Michigan. Powered by the love and support of our community, this Sac Supper also gets its life from teachers, who distribute the meals in their classrooms at the end of the day. Too many kids wonder where their next meal will come from and lack the essential nutrition needed to be successful. When paired with breakfast and lunch provided at school, Sac Suppers provide enough calories and food groups to meet each child's daily nutritional requirements, making every Sac Supper an important victory in the attack on childhood hunger.
Now down to Clayton's Cuisine for the lunch.
Hi, it's Clayton with Clayton's Cuisine today, and today for the lunch is meatball pasta bar with steamed broccoli and garlic toast. I give this a 7 out of 10. It doesn't taste like your mom's home spaghetti, but it's the school lunch.
Hello, and welcome to the fun fact of the day. Did you know that unlike popular belief, America does not have the highest obesity percentage in the world? It's true. It's actually a small country in Oceania called Nauru that has a population of 12,500 people, but 60% of the country is actually registered to be obese. And the lowest rates in the world come from Bangladesh with only 3.5%. That's pretty crazy if you ask me.
Thank you for joining us today, and thank you for watching. Have a great day, Eagles.